Hey, I'm Connor Jessup.
I'm Darby Stanchfield.
Hi, I'm Hallea Jones.
My name is Griffin Gluck.
I'm Gabriel Rodriguez.
I'm Joe Hill.
And this is your rule book to understanding the world of Locke and Key.
The world of Locke and Key is full of reality-bending, impossible keys. Keyhouse has 100 of these keys hidden away inside it. Every one of them opens a different lock and activates a different supernatural power.
The keys actually whisper. When they want to be found, they call out in a whispering tone.
They choose when is the right time for them to be found. And they choose who will find them and when.
But these keys want to be used as weapons.
The good and evil that can come from these keys is anything that the user of the key puts towards the intention of how they use the key, make the key, whatever it is.
When one is forging a key, the way they're made is by imbuing it with magical intention.
These keys are part of the Locke family. You know, they're almost like members of the Locke family. So locks have this bond with these keys.
The Locke family is blessed or cursed, or maybe a little bit of both.
For some reason, only the Locks can hear the keys, only the Locks can use the keys.
And basically they had the fortune, misfortune of having Keyhouse founded on the top of a gateway between dimensions.
And as long as they have the responsibility for protecting that gateway, they have the final power over the use of the keys.
If you're over 18 years old, you simply can't see the magic, you can't hear the magic.
It's almost like when you become an adult, you put on a raincoat, and suddenly all the magic just, it hits you, but it just sort of slides off you.
They can see it, they can perceive it, but the moment they turn away from it, the memory of it slips out of their heads.
Tyler realizes that he and Jackie are about to turn 18. They're about to become adults. And they know that adults can't remember magic. It becomes a real focus for Tyler to try and find a way to hold on to these memories.
No matter how hard the Locks try, the demons will always find its way back in, whether it be grief or whether it be school drama or actual literal demons.
Demons can spot our dimension, but can't get in freely.
The only way they can survive in our world is by taking possession of a human body. And if they come through the door and don't have a human body to leap into, they are turned into an inert metal. And the secret is every key is made out of a demon. Demons can't just pick up the keys and can't just take the keys away from the Locke family.
We have this connection. And because of that, through the mysteries of magic, demons can't take them from us.
And because the evil, the magic, the demon forms are so insidious in season 2, that rule is tested more than once.